Hello, programmers. Look at all the change I have. I want you to write a program that's going to input the number of nickels and dimes and quarters and figure out the total. The best part is you get to write this program all on your own. But you get to use the paycheck program as a reference. You can use the Mac or PC. You can even use the online compiler.
The video is divided into several sections to cover the coin counting project. The video discusses project definition, how to develop an algorithm. We will review the paycheck project, develop some test data and test the program, and document the project, the lab report. I suggest that you create a new folder on your computer or storage device for the counting change project. You can call your project counting change, total of coins, coin counter. You can choose any name you wish, but make sure that you do not use any spaces in your project name. Here is the project definition. Write a program that counts change. The program should ask for the number of quarters, the number of dimes, the number of nickels, and the number of pennies. Then the program should tell the user how much money there is expressed in dollars. You must use constants for the value of each coin type and display a title at the top of the screen when the program first runs. The first thing you should do when you are given a programming task is to figure out what the output should look like. Draw it out on paper. As the project progresses, don't worry if the actual program output does not look exactly like your original plan. Plans change. Put a title on the top of the output display that identifies your name and program, followed by a blank line. Your program does not need to display anything in colors. I'm only using red on my program outline to highlight the user's inputs. These values are to be read from the keyboard when the program runs, instead of being displayed as part of the prompt messages. When all of the inputs are read, display another blank line and then the total of all the coins in dollars. Let's see how the program looks when it is run. There is the title line at the top of the display. I am going to input 17 quarters, 23 dimes, 9 nickels, and 15 pennies. The program shows me that I have $7.15. Your program should look something like this when it runs. The text of your program does not need to look exactly like mine. Instead of a prompt message that looks like, "How many quarters do you have?" your program could say, "Number of quarters," or "Input the number of quarters." The output could even say, "You have," and then "How much money," instead of "Your total is." Feel free to customize the text that is displayed, but be polite. In a hierarchy input process output chart, also called a hypo chart, we need to identify the inputs and the outputs. Once we know the inputs and outputs, we then need to decide how to get from the input all the way to the output. We're going to read the number of quarters, dimes, nickels, and pennies. Compute the total of all the coins and then display that value on the screen. This program is only using numeric data for the number of coins, their values, and total value of all the coins. We need to choose which of the numeric data types to use in the program. The int data type can only be used for whole numbers. The int data type is a great choice for the number of each coin type. We can't input half a quarter or even a penny, but we will need to use the double data type for the value of each coin and the total value of all the coins expressed in dollars and cents. If we define int variables for quarters, dimes, nickels, and pennies, then the total can be computed as dollars equals quarter times 0.25 plus dimes times 0.10 plus nickels times 0.05 plus pennies times 0.10. And I need a semicolon at the end. Part of the project definition states that a constant must be used for the coin values. In that case, we need to define a constant for the value of quarter, etc. Total equal quarters times quarter value plus dimes times dime value, etc. Note, since the statement does not end until the semicolon is reached, this statement can cover more than one line. Let's review how to define the equivalent of a constant in Java. Public static final. Double quarter value equal 0.25, semicolon. You can use the paycheck program as a reference when you develop the counting change program. You can get the source code for the paycheck program from the class website or go directly to http://program-info.net/java/downloads/java-paycheck/java-paycheck-code.gif. If the text is too small on this slide, don't worry about reading it yet. I will zoom in for different parts during the discussion. The title block at the top of the program file uses the block style comments, starting with the slash star and ending with a star slash. The comment block identifies what is in the file, as well as the inputs and outputs. Some companies want the programmer's name in the title block. Others don't. I want your name in the title block, and I will look for it when I grade your projects. Although not shown here, a couple other things that are usually placed in the title block are the version number and the date. This can help determine the latest version of the code when there are multiple files that are not the same. Before going any further in writing your project, you need to decide on which routines you want to use for keyboard input. The scanner object is the most common way to input data from the keyboard, but it behaves badly if the user types something that scanner was not expecting. David Eck, the author of the textbook, has provided a Java class named Text.io. Before going any further in writing your program, you need to decide on which routines you want to use for keyboard input. The scanner object is the most common way to input data from the keyboard, but it behaves badly if the user types something that scanner was not expecting. David Eck, the author of the textbook, has provided a Java class named Text.io that makes inputting from the keyboard much nicer. If you're going to use scanner to input data from the keyboard, then you need to 1. Type import java.util.scanner as the second line of code. 2. Create the scanner standard in object, shown on a later slide. 3. To read numbers of quarters from the keyboard, type quarters equal stdin.nextint, open close parentheses semicolon. Keep using standard in.nextint for dimes, nickels, and pennies. At the end of the program, type stdin.close, open close parentheses, semicolon. If you're going to use the text.io routines provided in the textbook, then you need to 1. Put a copy of the text.io.java file in the same folder as your counting change.java program and use the statement import text.io.text.io, semicolon. Look closely at the characters on the import statement. Some are capitalized and some are not. 2. To read the number of quarters from the keyboard, type quarters equal text.io.getlineInt. So that's GETLN INT. Use text.io.getlineInt again to read the number of dimes, nickels, and pennies. Use constants for the value of a quarter, dime, nickel, and penny. Here is how the paycheck program defined a constant for overtime rate. Use capital letters and the underscore when declaring constants and a comment if the constant's name does not perfectly make it clear. By using public static final double overtime underscore rate equals 1.5. We now have a value 1.5 stored in memory. The Paycheck program is using the double data type for all its variables. This is the place in the Counting Change program where you need to define the int variables for the number of quarters, dimes, nickels, and pennies. You need a double for the dollars because it needs to show digits past the decimal. If you're going to use Scanner to input from the keyboard, then you need to create the Scanner object. If you're going to use the Text.io routines to input from the keyboard, you don't need to create the Scanner standard in object. For each coin type, quarters, dimes, nickels, and pennies, you need a system.outprint statement to output a prompt to the console screen, asking the user to input something followed by a keyboard input. Remember to input an integer using either Scanner or Text.io when inputting coin counts. Quarters equal STDIN, next int, or quarters equal Text.io get line int. You also need to do something similar to this to read the number of dimes, nickels, and pennies from the keyboard. The computations for the total dollar and cents value of all the coins is much easier than the computation in the Paycheck program. All you need to do is use the number of each coin multiplied by its value and add it to the total. Review the Paycheck program on how to display the paycheck with two decimal places. You only need a blank line before displaying the total. Close the Scanner object if using Scanner instead of Text.io. Here are the values for the number of quarters, dimes, and nickels and pennies that I have chosen. I want you to choose different values. The first two rows should work okay. I want you to test the program when at least one of the values entered is a zero. Although we have not covered how to process unexpected inputs yet, I want you to test the program and find out what happens if either nothing is entered or letters are entered for nickels. Project documentation and lab report. Complete and submit the lab report. Congratulations on completing your first Java program that you have written on your own. I look forward to seeing you in the next module. Bye for now.